What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Gum Botton. It's your host, G Sneaks, here on the G Sneaks 89 Network. And today we're introducing the G Sneaks News, which is a new segment where we're going to discuss a lot of things going down in our culture, from politics to sports to sneakers to everything. So we're about to introduce something new, something crazy. We got a lot of good topics today. Today we're discussing sports. We got a couple big sports things going on right now, from trades to fights to everything like that. So we're about to get into it, man. Stay tuned. All right, guys, now since we're talking sports, we got to talk the Cleveland Cavaliers. Just recently, we got wind that Kyrie Irving said he didn't want to play with LeBron James no more. And that's kind of crazy seeing that everybody's saying LeBron James is the best player in the world. I've never heard nobody or nobody ever came forward and said that they didn't want to play with Jordan. But this is the second time that we got team friction with LeBron James. The first time was with Delonte West and himself. And supposedly, that was the reason why he took his talents down to South Beach. But now, he didn't have to leave. Kyrie Irving did. So just recently, he was traded to the Boston Celtics for Isaiah Thomas and a couple other things to help equalize that trade. So how do you feel about that? I know it's a lot of Cleveland Cavaliers fans out there, including one of my best friends. So I haven't even talked to him yet. I'm really interested to see on how he feel. Because, you know, he loved LeBron, he loved Kyrie, but now they done took that split. But also, one of the biggest things I want to know was what made him get off that team so fast? Because this trade went down in a couple of weeks. You know what I'm saying? And usually, teams not really willing to give up their star player like that. I know LeBron James is a star, but Kyrie Irving is a co-star. Probably the best point guard in the league right now. Arguably one or two after Steph. So I'm trying to see what possessed Kyrie to want off that team so bad that he went to the front office and demanded he be traded. And then they got the deal done fairly quickly. It took much longer than just to try to find a new home for Carmelo Anthony, which I don't believe has happened yet. But still, so like, let me know what you know. Let me know how you feel about the trade, all you Cleveland Cavaliers fans. And also, they are reigning Eastern Conference champions. On LeBron teams, they don't seem to care that they're the reigning Eastern Conference champions, because LeBron went back to Cleveland as the reigning Eastern Conference champion. Kyrie Irving gets traded to the Boston Celtics while he's the reigning Eastern Conference champion. So nobody in the East is really into defending their Eastern Conference champion. I mean, it's not the NBA champion, but it's the trophy for being the best team in the East. So they're always willing to abandon those teams, even though they're reigning and have to defend their title as the Eastern Conference champion. So let me know what you feel about that, man, because I think it's a little fishy. I think it's something going on. I don't know, but it's kind of crazy for them to just part ways like that. And I'm interested in seeing that game, Boston Celtics versus Cleveland Cavaliers. So let's get it, man. Let me know how you feel about that. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Let me hear something about that. Let's go. All right, now it's time for the meat and potatoes. The biggest news in sports going down right now, which takes place this Saturday, Las Vegas. Conor McGregor taking on the GOAT himself, Floyd Money Mayweather. And y'all already know, man, May Day is a holiday over here at G-Sneaks. You know what I'm saying? I just love the parties. I love just watching Mayweather fight. You know what I'm saying? He's probably one of the greatest fighters of all time, but he's definitely the greatest fighter of my era, the current era we're in right now. Even though his time is passing and he plans to retire after this fight, as of right now, he's the greatest boxer for me to ever view with my own eyes. You know what I'm saying? Especially as far as defense. So his last fight, as of right now, number 50, goes down this Saturday. He's taking on a UFC fighter, Conor McGregor, in a boxing matchup, which is going to be crazy. And I think people are actually out there thinking that Mayweather might go down, which I think is extraordinarily to believe. You know what I'm saying? I don't believe that. The odds that Conor McGregor will get in the ring for his boxing debut. Now, mind you, this is boxing debut. He's going to get in the ring for the first time with probably the greatest defensive fighter that we've ever seen. He's going to knock him out. Chances are slim to none, but the rumors and everything is speculating, so we would definitely like to hear from you guys, hear from the viewers. We need to know. Make sure you comment. We need the comments. We need to know how y'all feel about this fight, because we're doing a before the fight right now, but we also going to have a post-fight conversation to go over it afterwards, because gotta prove y'all wrong, you know what I'm saying? Everybody that says McGregor gonna knock him out, we gotta prove y'all wrong come Saturday, Sunday. So I need to know, you know what I'm saying? Because no way in hell am I gonna bet against the champ 49-0. You know what I'm saying? So there's no reason for me to bet against the champ. You're going with Mayweather all day over here. So how do you feel? Let us know. You think Conor might have a chance? Because I don't think it's a chance at all. I think it's going to be a knockout inside 8 rounds. I say within that first 8 rounds, Mayweather going to knock him out. And I think it's going to be pretty much of a different, you're going to see a different class of fighter. You know what I'm saying? I just don't think McGregor is ready. I think in a couple fights, I think he's going to be really something to wreck with in that welterweight division or middleweight division, but I don't think so. Not tonight. Not Saturday night. No, not close. He's going to get outclassed the same way he did Canelo Alvarez. I still think Canelo was Mayweather's probably most dangerous opponent. Somewhat with Maidana. I didn't get into the hype with Maidana. I actually thought he won both fights clearly, and there wasn't no reason for a rematch. But that's my opinion. I'm sure y'all gonna attack those speculations down in the comments. But yeah, I really believe that this is, you know, we're gonna miss Mayweather. You know what I'm saying? Just the event and the crowd and the atmosphere that he brings to the sport of boxing, man. We're gonna really miss this. And that's why I chose to really bring this topic up, because win or loss, we're not going to really see this too many, you know, demanding of attention fights that go down in boxing, like the old heavyweights, like with Mike Tyson and Muhammad Ali used to fight. Although that Triple G and fight is going to be pretty dope, because I follow all aspects of boxing. But as of right now, we're going to miss Mayweather, you know what I'm saying? And so for this to be the last Mayday that we probably will see, I expect him to go out with a bang. So I'm predicting that McGregor gets knocked out within those 8 rounds. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go on and say 6 now. I'm gonna go on and say 6. Within the first 6 rounds, McGregor should be on his back. So like I said, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Let me know how you feel about what I just said. If you know how you feel about Kyrie trade, McGregor, Mayweather, LeBron, biggest news in sports going on right now. Let's get it, man. We here at GSNKS 89, the Gum Botton. We have the GSNKS news segment, new segment going down. Like I said, we got all the best topics, whatever's going on at the top of the key right now, you're going to hear it. Let's get it. GSNKS.